Welcome everybody to the Top Back Podcast, the show where we share our love for nerd culture for your entertainment. I'm one of your hosts, Matt.
And I'm Mike.
And today, we're going to do a review, our first movie review on Godzilla vs. Kong, which just came out on HBO Max. And one of the most highly anticipated movies of this year.
Yup.
Yeah.
I was juiced for it. when it was announced after Godzilla King of Monsters. I don't remember a lot of people getting hyped for it, and then I think everybody just got hyped on it for some goddamn reason. But
it's because we don't have a lot of stuff to watch. That's
why. I know. I was like, where did all these fans come from? Seriously, I was hyped for this.
So Godzilla vs. Kong is the, I guess it's the sequel to Godzilla King of Monsters and Kong Skull Island.
Yep.
Kong Skull Island, I just watched this year, so I have a little more context with King Kong now. I'm going to start off with you, Mike. So what'd you think of Godzilla vs. Kong?
Just first impressions?
Yeah.
Just compared to all the other MonsterVerse movies, like it was a little bit less humans, more fighting this time with the actual monsters. Mm-hmm. And that's what everybody wanted to see.
Did you watch the first one?
I watched all of them.
You watched all of them?
I watched all of them in theaters.
Okay. So I watched the first one only once. Once. And I hated it. Up until the
there's only like 7 minutes of Kong.
Right,
I mean,
right.
Godzilla.
Right, and that was like a 2-hour movie.
Exactly,
that was a fucking long
movie.
But
this movie here, like Godzilla versus Kong, you actually saw them fucking fight
from the jump, pretty much.
The jump, yeah, literally Kong jumping. Mm-hmm. So going into it, I already didn't care for the humans. They brought back Team Godzilla, which is like Millie Bobby Brown.
Yeah,
they introduced two more characters, and then you have the Kong Team Kong side. So like I already like didn't really care for them. Their whole story was just, it was okay.
Mm-hmm.
But I think this movie, first impression, I think this movie gave what I wanted to see, which is like an actual throwdown.
Okay.
A heavyweight matchup of two titans. A god versus, he's not a King Kong yet, but he's Kong.
Wrath of the Titans though.
Yeah.
So I'll say this first. I think this is my favorite out of the Godzilla movies, the trilogy. So I did really like King of Monsters because I watched it on the plane back from Japan, ironically.
Gaika.
I know, in a storm, too. That was like, what the fuck? It's like Godzilla out here. Yeah, this movie was good. Good. We'll get into detail about it.
Yeah.
But I think out of all the... Skull Island was really good.
Yeah,
I think Kong Skull Island was probably the best one, story-wise, for sure. And acting wise, for fucking sure, because this movie, when we get into the human characters, I was not impressed at all by anybody.
Yeah.
This is really, it really was about Godzilla versus Kong, but I wanted to see more from the humans because we have so much time with them. Because they take up 80% of the movie.
But compared to like the first two Godzilla movies, there's less humans.
Yeah, that's sad though, because it's still too much for me.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I think. Before we talk about like how the movie was, before we talk about the result, before you watch the movie, who did you favor more?
Godzilla.
Yeah. I was favoring Godzilla. And then I look back at the original film,
right?
And you knew like Kong was gonna get a weapon at some point.
Mm-hmm.
I was like,
did
for
you?
Me, I think
that was a surprise for me. I didn't know anything about that.
That Kong was gonna get a weapon.
Yeah.
Because if you saw, remember Skull Island, mm-hmm. he made a weapon out of the tree.
Yeah, because he does this like.
Yeah, he's intelligent. Yeah, so like, and then that Kong was smaller, so they had to make him like the size of Godzilla, and I think they did it really well by scaling him.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I saw the scale and I saw the trailers, I was like, okay, I think Kong has a little bit more. It's not like David versus Goliath. Mm-hmm. I think Kong has a lot more to offer.
Right.
But the movie, the result.
I mean, who's the first name on the poster?
Godzilla.
Right?
Yeah. Godzilla's the king. He's the king of monsters.
And, so I was confused in the very beginning because I was like, when did they capture Kong? I don't remember that happening in Skull Island.
So the fact like that Skull Island is discovered and they made it known within like Monarch.
Mm-hmm.
Like they didn't talk about like that backstory. I think there was a comic before this or some shit, like a pre-story. I didn't look it up.
Yeah. But I don't like when they do that shit.
They basically like showed off that Kong was... Like the very first scene, I didn't know it was a simulated area. I like how they presented it. It was like that music was playing and Kong woke up scratching in his ass. I was like, I think that set the tone. Like, okay, this is Kong is like us, or like, you know, the evolutionary
pre-evolutionary
shit. And then you find out that Kong's in this big dome.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, how the fuck did you capture him?
Exactly.
First of all,
the way they explained it was like so weird, because they explained it later that like a storm wiped out the Iwis from that island.
Right.
And then I was like, okay, I knew the girl was gonna be in it, but I didn't know she was the last person of her race. And that was like, to me, that was like a gripe from the beginning. I was like,
okay. Her race or tribe, you mean?
Her tribe, okay. Or whatever. Yeah. Same shit. Like this woman is taking care of this girl. She adopted her. Mm-hmm. And then later on in the movie, she's like, oh, she can't come with us. I'm like, bitch, you got this fucking girl with you everywhere you go with this tall ass ape, and you're going to start being responsible now?
Yeah, I thought she was the best actor in the movie.
The little girl?
Yeah. She was, baby girl was the.
Yeah, if I had a daughter, that's how I want my daughter to be.
She was really adorable. Yeah. And was she deaf in real life? I don't know.
I don't know, but it reminded me of like Mighty Joe Young. I think Mighty Joe Young had something like that. You remember that?
He just unlocked something in the back of my head. I haven't heard that.
I think Kong is like the human favorite, because you can relate to Kong a little bit more, like intelligence-wise and all that.
Right.
So I like how they played the little girl being more important, because she's the only one who can fucking communicate
with him. Yeah, I like the fact that she was and later in the movie he was like, I can't speak to him, he can speak to us. He didn't want you guys to know.
Yeah, but I was like, how is that possible? This is a dome. I'm pretty sure they have security.
You can see it, right?
Like, you like can't
that,
see this
movie? That looks like sign language, but maybe not. I don't know. Like, but yeah. I don't know.
There's a lot of plot holes.
There's so many fucking plot holes. I was just really confused in the whole movie. Yeah. Like, I really didn't give a fuck about any of the groups.
Yeah.
Like, Apex is one. Mm. Monarchs is one, right?
Yeah, so it was like...
Then the podcast guy was one.
Yeah.
Paperboy.
Shout out to podcasters. Right. When they said podcasters, I was like, all right, you making fun of all us pandemic podcasters.
It was like episode 207. Like, goddamn, dude, you've been doing this hella long.
And see, that's the plot hole too. I'm like, this dude is trying to expose this company, and no one fucking like security knew what this guy was doing.
Right.
Like putting a USB and getting the information. I'm like, that's so fucking like stupid. Like, security in this movie is horrible all around. Apex, and I didn't even hear about Apex until this movie. I was like, I thought we were Monarch still. Mm-hmm. And Apex, once you hear like talk about like the prosthetics, I was like, I know where this is fucking going.
You saw that coming?
Because like the post credit scene of King of Monsters,
they had post credit scenes.
Yeah,
too?
They do.
For
King of Monsters.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
It was like
doesn't
Ghidorah's matter. Head was one of his heads was retrieved. Uh-huh. So you know that I was gonna play later.
Okay, gotcha.
Like off of like the Toho films.
Yeah,
it's like a Galvatron moment.
Yeah, I liked. I mean, Godzilla's been kind of the same, like since the first movie.
How do you like this Godzilla design compared to like the ones we grew up to?
He has a fucking tiny ass head.
Yeah, he does.
It's like his body shape is like it goes very small, all hella big. Here.
Yeah,
and like this. He's supposed to be a lizard. I get that.
Godzilla's body type here is like really husky.
Mm-hmm.
I think they made him that way. And like, he's like the dude, like that dude in high school who was hella scrawny. And then college, he discovers protein shakes and he got hella big. The other movies, I would say this Godzilla is the most limber.
Agile, for sure. Agile. Yeah.
He actually moves like a
lizard. I know. There's one scene late when they were fighting in Hong Kong later. I was like, damn, he kind of moved quick.
Yeah.
He did the stomp and then he dashed
forward. The other movies, he did not move like that.
I know. He was
like
very
that.
Stocky and like heavy, but this one he had like, he, I don't know, he lost weight or something.
Yeah, it's like when LeBron like loses weight and more like on that paleo diet.
Yeah. He looked good. Godzilla. I always love it when he does his charge shots, though. That's always my favorite part of the movie. His iconic screech. I would never try to do it.
I was Godzilla for kindergarten.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, which one?
The 98 one. That one was horrible.
The Matthew Broderick one?
Yeah, Go-Go Gadget. Yeah. That one was horrible. That was such a shame. Even like the Godzilla folks franchise.
That was actually my first... That was ironic. I didn't think about that. That was the first movie I ever watched in the drive-in. Mm-hmm. And then I watched the most recent, the first Godzilla of this trilogy in the drive-thru with Sam, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was like, I didn't put that together.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That was like 15 years apart.
Yeah, I know.
That's insane.
That's the thing, though. I didn't remember anything about that movie.
Did you watch the Godzilla cartoon before? Like on
the one on Fox? It was trash.
But you saw other monsters, though. So I think King of Monsters was good because like I saw other monsters.
Right, right.
This one, like, we got two Titans.
Right.
I was wondering where was like Mothra this whole time.
I know. That's what I'm saying. That, I feel like there should have been a little bit more Titans involved.
Yeah, like what are they doing in world?
They're still, because they have eggs or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. I didn't really understand the story. Yeah. I didn't understand why they're going against each other. Did you pick that
up? That was so fucking like, okay. We really dissect this movie. Uh-huh. It was so convenient, like, especially at the end, like the whole like Hong Kong scene. But the whole point of like Godzilla fighting a Kong, apparently Godzilla can sense that Kong is another alpha male. That's what the lady was explaining. So they said that if Kong is outside his dome, Godzilla's gonna sense him and knock him out. Like if you feel like another alpha apex predator is out there. But that's so stupid. Like,
well, they said
because the storm is protecting the island.
Oh,
so
I don't Skull know. Island or
Skull Island. Okay. So I don't know if Godzilla can access that island, but it's like Kong is just gonna chill on his island.
They're saying that their species were always like ancestral species went head to head
exactly
at times. So yeah,
how do they know that?
I don't know.
Where's the like exposition is exposition. Sometimes it's used too much, but I feel like they could have like. Like the dark side scene in Snyder Cut. Like, give me a flashback or something. Like, show me some scriptures on the wall.
They did, though.
They had in the other movies, like the cave paintings.
Yeah.
But I wanted to see a little bit more. How'd you know there was other Godzilla?
Right. I think I would have been more satisfied if he just came across each other on accident. I think I would have believed that more. Than exactly. They made it seem like this was meant to happen at some point. So I don't like that kind of shit. Every time a movie tries to put a prophecy in it, I hate that shit so much. That's too convenient.
True.
Yeah, I really hate that.
They were trying to say like, oh yeah, this isn't the waters that Godzilla normally travels.
Yeah.
But Godzilla still found them.
Out of the whole, out of thousands and thousands of miles of water, that's where he found them.
Oh my God.
This movie answered the question though, who would win in the fight? Godzilla, bro.
Fuck yeah.
Godzilla. He got him on water. He got him on land. Yeah. I think Kong won once, like... The fucker even said that like round
that was horrible writing. He's like,
that's what I'm saying.
Oh, he run round two and then like the fight wasn't even over. Dumbass. Okay, so like if we talk about the humans, Skarsgård, I forgot his name. Nathan, right? The guy that plays Nathan, the brother of like the other Skarsgård brother, the one that plays it, and the son of like Bootstrap Bill, the Skarsgård, from Thor, the scientist. Well, the scientist here, he's like family actors, whatever. He was horrible, bro. Like, he was a horrible character, like scientist.
Everybody was fucking horrible.
I didn't feel like he was smart at all. Like, he just like went with the rich white guy, or I don't even know white, but like he went with the rich guy, went along with the plan,
right?
Explained like, oh yeah, my brother died in this expedition. He made it seem like, oh yeah, my brother died in the Hollow Earth.
Mm-hmm.
How the fuck did you come back then? The fuck? There's so many plot holes.
Fucking Millie Bobby Brown was fucking useless too. Like I didn't.
But they minimized her at least a little bit.
They shouldn't even have her. That's the thing. Exactly. Like they added her thing with a what's the name from Deadpool 2?
Yeah.
I was surprised to see him. I was like, oh shit.
I think they just wanted like minorities in it a little bit.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah.
That was like the minority group.
Yeah. Exactly.
That shit was whack as fuck though. I didn't like any of that.
I didn't like
their whole plot was just to reveal fucking Mechagodzilla
Robo-Godzilla.
Bro, fuck. When that shit, I didn't know he was gonna be in the film because you saw that obviously, but I was like, because I loved Mechagodzilla, his design back in the day. I had the toy.
Yeah, exactly.
I was like, I didn't know he was gonna be here. When I saw that, I was like, I was pretty hyped. But when they revealed his name, Paperboy was like, it's Robot Godzilla. And then fucking, what's his name? It's like, no.
No,
it's Mechagodzilla. I was like, this isn't a known thing, motherfucker. Like, he's not wrong. It is Robot Godzilla. It's like, they'll try to correct his ass.
It's like stating the obvious.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, Kong lost round.
Right.
Kong won round two. Like, what the fuck? Like, you don't have to narrate. Like, you might as well put a narrator.
That's what I'm saying. Robot means mecha, bro. It's the same shit. That's like saying... Red Godzilla. No, that's Blood Godzilla. I don't fucking know. Some shit like that. It's like, it's the same shit, bro. Yeah, there's the writing in this fucking movie just pissed me off.
Really bad.
I was just waiting. I was patiently waiting. Like, can we get back to the monsters real quick? Because, like, whatever they're saying, I'm not interested at all. But I like the set pieces, though, when they actually did fight. Mm-hmm. Like, the first fight on the water. I like the fact that he flipped the whole boat aside. Hold on, let me talk about that girl real quick.
The Jay, Jay or something.
The Latin girl, right?
Oh, the Latin girl. Yeah, the Latin girl. Oh, the Simmons girl. She was bad though.
She was bad as fuck, but she was useless. I was like, bro, what the fuck? She barely said shit. You're not intimidating. It's like you're really just here just to look good.
Yeah.
It's like we don't need you. Like, and then Kong fucking killed her ass anyway. So yeah. It's like
this movie did a horrible job of like playing into the film tropes of like useless characters. Mm. Like a small group of people that you just don't give a shit about.
Right.
Like that pretty girl, like, we already knew she's going to die. It's like a horror movie. It's like,
I knew she was going to die. I didn't think she was going to last long.
Yeah. And
so here's the thing about Godzilla movies. There always has to be a human aspect because that's how you're supposed to tell the story. You can't just have the monsters. But if you're going to have the humans, you have to make... The one thing that the Japanese Godzilla did well, the original one, you have to include the politics.
Yeah.
So
that's where Godzilla came from, right, too. The exactly. social commentary.
Yeah, about the Hiroshima bomb and like the wars. It's like a reflection of that. Mm-hmm. That's what made Godzilla great in the first place.
Yeah.
These movies, he's just a regular old monster that just lived millions of years and that just awoke. That's like the most basic of Godzilla storytelling. Mm-hmm. So if the humans suck, like, the whole movie's going to suck because we all want to see Godzilla, but you got to build around it. You can't build around the fights. You have to build to the fight.
You have to have that build up, like the stakes that are going into it. And, you know, the first impressions matter. If the first movie really bad with Kick-Ass and Wanda Maximoff, Quicksilver, like...
I already forgot about that movie.
Exactly. Yeah. So if you don't have a good start, then how can you bond with them for like two more movies later? Right. Like Millie Bobby Brown, like, yeah, she's a great young actress, whatever. Mm-hmm. And in the first movie, or her movie, the second one, they had that family drama, but it was too much family drama.
Mm-hmm.
Here, it's like, okay, we had a girl from the franchise. She's here with us, but they just threw her around and just for convenience sake. It did a
bunch of nothing. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like plot device of like, oh, somehow she's in Hong Kong in several hours. Like, what the fuck?
Right. And they treated Kong like a slave too.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. I was feeling really bad. First of all, they got him in shackles when they're trying to transport him. And then motherfucker was out in the rain. I was like, damn, you guys are really... Humans are the worst, bro.
Yeah.
People are the fucking worst. And then when they're transporting him to the Antarctica, he's cold as fuck. It's like, you guys are fucked up, dude.
Oh yeah, they
the scientist girl, what's her name?
I don't even fucking know her name. Okay,
yeah, see, she was like, "We're trying to help him. You're not helping him right now.
Exactly,
he's having hypothermia right now."
It's like, oh, he has to go through the hole, right? And then Kong looked back. He was like, "Fuck, that's a long way home." And he started shaking. I was like,
I know.
Oh my God.
That's what I'm saying. You guys treat him like shit. Like a goddamn slave.
On that boat, and I remember they like fed him. He was like eating the fish. I was like, okay. I feel for you, man. They're fucking treating you like a prisoner.
He's starving right now, bro. Bro.
Like they never explain shit. Like, how did they set it?
Is King Kong an allegory for African Americans?
I don't know.
The original one. I don't know.
Yeah, I forget. That movie was like 1933, right. And then like.
Did you ever watch the Peter Jackson one?
I did.
Yeah,
I actually liked that one because that was like a remake of the 1933.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we're big Lord of the Rings fans.
Right.
And then the Peter Jackson one, the dad, Millie Bobby Brown's dad,
yeah,
was in that King Kong movie in 2005.
Oh, her actual dad?
No, not the actual dad. The movie dad. So he played two different Kong and
I didn't know that.
So yeah, it was pretty cool.
Yeah.
But
that
like,
movie was long as fuck. That's all that I remember.
That was very long.
I couldn't watch it. I never finished it. Like,
and it's like very. I mean, the guy that plays Gollum, he was also Kong.
Yeah, he was
also Kong too. So like, I think I don't know who played Kong and Godzilla, but like, I see the evolution of like how the films were made, Godzilla and Kong. Back in the day to now, it's like, wow, you came a long way.
Yeah, come a long way. Some of the, what'd you think about the CGI effects though?
I liked it. I actually,
you didn't mind it?
I didn't mind it at all. Like, the Kong and Godzilla, like, I really wish I saw this in the movie theater.
I know. I was actually gonna ask you if you wanted to.
Man, I wanted to ask you, but I was too shy.
Really?
I was gonna ask you to go.
I might have been down
in San Jose.
I was saying
8 o'clock.
Though. Yeah, yeah. I was saying at actual theater.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm comfortable with that yet.
Yeah. I think they social distance too. So.
Yeah.
But it's been a minute,
dude.
Bro.
The box office was like, oh, Kong had $9 million this weekend. I was like, God damn it, we've sunken so low.
Here's the thing I heard about this movie. So I heard they have this whole MonsterVerse set up, but actually this is supposed to be like the peak. Yeah, like I don't think they have a real plan after this because this is pretty much what everything's been leading to.
Yeah.
So they don't really have anything else.
And it also has to do with like rights too, because like Warner Brothers, Legendary, and all those studios, I think they might be losing the rights of Godzilla
really
at some point. So it's like the director said it too. It's like, let's just make a movie now, not put expectations at the end. Kind of like, not everything have to be MCU. We have post credits.
This already was, though.
It was, but like, I think the director made it point. He's like, okay, let's see how it does, and then we'll build off of it.
I don't think it's going to perform that well, because the other ones didn't perform that well. So
yeah, and
the pandemic's going to fuck it up.
Yeah. So. But I think, for fans' sakes, I think this movie did really... I think I enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it too. I was gonna say this movie, it's really stupid when you think about
it.
It's really, you
break it
stupid.
Down. It's fucking dumb.
But the actual action, I didn't mind it.
Okay, let's talk about that. The fight, the water scene.
The first one.
Yeah. Okay, like because it's Godzilla's territory. Water. You already know Godzilla's going to fucking win.
Exactly.
Did you catch like the Jaws stuff? Like he was like circling around like Jaws, like shark.
Yeah, I mean he does that.
He dragged the boat too. That was like a
Jaws too. Oh, I didn't know that was a Jaws reference.
So I was like, oh fuck, Godzilla's really tearing shit up.
Yeah, yeah, that's his territory. I knew he was gonna win that, so I was like, let's get going, like get it going, get it going.
Did you feel the Did you feel the punches though? Like,
yeah,
I felt it. I was
the impacts and the way they shot it, or the cinematography was really good.
Yeah.
I mean, King Kong, he only has like a couple things.
He's not King Kong.
Oh, is that really how it is?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's not king. Oh, he's king of his island, but like no one references as King Kong yet.
Oh, that's true. Because
there's a king of monsters.
Right. But
Godzilla's and Kong is only
the king. He's not going to win because he lost all the fucking rounds, bro. Unless Godzilla dies. You're not going to be King Kong ever.
You mentioned it earlier where like how he was underwater. I was like, oh, it's over. And then Kong...
I already knew that was going to happen.
Kong flipped the boat.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what if Kong never flipped that boat? All those people died.
People would have died, bro.
I like how Kong saw Godzilla going to the other boat, right? And Kong was like, fuck. So he jumped. But he made sure he didn't jump so hard. Like, that he gave damage to the ship and then jumped to the other one.
He tried to add a little finesse there.
Yeah.
No, it was good. It was really good. And then, what?
I got to say this. When Godzilla shot his beam and Kong was like, oh, shit. And he jumped. Oh! It's like that Jay-Z when he jumped in the swimming pool. You remember that meme back in the day? Look that up.
I'll look it up.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it was a really good fight. But the main fight, the one in Hong Kong, that was really good. Like, that was pretty much what I wanted. But honestly, I wish it was a little bit longer.
Yeah.
Like they added a little more choreography to it.
Mm-hmm.
It was good, though. I really liked it. What did you think about the whole Hollow Earth shit? I was really, really confused. Like, I watched all the movies, but for some reason, I didn't really pay attention to all the stuff.
I felt like I was in Tron when they had the flying ship, whatever. Because, like, whatever tech they had in 2017, 2015, because this is 5 years later, their tech all of a sudden was, like, Apex was, like, fucking 100 years from now.
Every movie is a five-year jump. Did you realize
that?
Yeah,
but it's, like, let's say it's 2023 in that movie, right? Right.
I know, it's way too...
I don't think they have that fucking tech in 2023.
They're not going to have a Godzilla either.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
A mecha Godzilla.
But it's, like, I was, like, it's so, like, when you're flying with that ship and then you go into the Hollow Earth, like it looks cool visually,
yeah.
But when you follow Kong, the arena,
you know
how there was like that big power source mountain,
yeah.
And then there was a door, and there was a fucking coliseum, paved seats, paved stairs.
It was the one time Kong looked in scale with everything.
Yeah.
I was like, did they really build this like arena for the monkeys or something?
Yeah.
Like
who
that?
Built that?
I know. I was like,
the fucking aliens.
No, they did, obviously, but I didn't think they're this intelligent.
I know. That's
like,
why
I was really confused.
That's why I said, I was like, are you fucking kidding me? There must have been like these fucking apes paved the fucking stairs, and then there's a throne.
They're like the Mayans.
And fucking Kong got his axe like Mjolnir and like was like Stormbreaker.
I know, for real.
I'm sorry, I'm like yelling because like I just found that part of the movie really fucking dumb.
The concept of Hollow Earth is a real thing. Like,
yeah.
That's a real concept.
But why'd you make a palace?
Right. It's supposed to be old Earth or like
prehistoric times.
Prehistoric times, but like I don't even know how to explain it really.
I don't even think they know how to explain it.
That's what I'm saying. That's why they didn't really do a good job of like it's where the monsters dwell.
Yeah.
That's where they originated from. But bringing him back there, I didn't really understand why they brought him back.
It was like a big side mission.
Because he had his own island. Like, he was chilling.
Yeah.
I was like why did
that island has a hollow Earth entrance too. Right. Why didn't you go there?
Like, he had his whole habitat situated. Like, and now you bring it to this fucking hollow Earth.
Yeah.
I like the first fight, though, he had with the monster. That was good. That was pretty cool. I didn't realize he had this whole thing of fucking... he did it in the first movie, too, where he tears the head off and he eats it. And it's like... he does that every time.
He's like a baby.
He's like, I don't even care what it tastes like. I'm just going to...
I don't know if this is organic.
I know.
Oh, it's organic. It has no GMOs. It doesn't live upstairs with us.
And I was like, that is kind of gross. The fucking Latin girl said it, too. I felt it.
Yeah. You know, remember when Kong was like... He jumped. Right,
mm-hmm.
That mountain looked like the Sistine, like a hand.
Yeah,
it looked like the Sistine Chapel. It did. I was like, "What the fuck is going on?" Yeah,
the way gravity works in this. First of all, I don't even know how sun.
That's what I said. Yeah. Where's the lighting coming from? Yeah,
where's the sun coming through? Because if it's in the Earth and there's no escape, I don't understand how the sun can appear like that. It would just be like a hole with light. You know what I mean?
My God.
Yeah, so I really don't understand the concept of what they're trying to do.
Because the guy, the rich guy, hired them to get the power source.
Right.
To power up his Mechagodzilla.
Right.
I'm like, you put too much like weight into the Hollow Earth. You could have just simplified it with Hollow Earth being like another way to get to the other side of the planet.
Whatever. Yeah, that's basically
because they didn't
was.
Have no boats anymore.
Right.
What if they heard that like Godzilla tearing shit up in Hong Kong?
Mm-hmm.
Oh shit, let's just go to the nearest entrance,
mm-hmm.
Antarctica, whatever. We'll meet Kong there because Kong can't swim.
Right.
And when Kong was flown to Antarctica, that's a play on like the original movie of mm-hmm. them on Kong got delivered by balloons.
Oh, that's right. That's right. You're right. Yeah,
so it's like, okay, I like that. But the fact that Kong was fucking freezing hyperthermia.
Treating like bullshit, dude.
God fucking.
So that axe he was holding, right? Is that made from Godzilla's?
Like the dwarf.
The
fin. That's what they're implying.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I got from it. It's like, I was like, I really don't get this shit.
It's so fucking dumb, dude.
Everything is just too convenient. Yeah. And I know this movie is supposed to be for fun, but if you're really trying to build a story.
Yeah.
Like I said, I don't like when things are too convenient and it's like prophesized shit like that. That's really basic writing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But
did you see the markings on the ground was like Godzilla too?
Was it?
Yeah.
When it lit up?
Yeah.
I didn't realize.
I was like, because when Kong put the axe in the thing, how did Kong know to put the axe right there? How did he put it right there, Kong?
Fucking scientists know what the fuck was going on.
And what was happening? Godzilla sensed Mechagodzilla in Hong Kong. And then he sends Kong, get the hammer. So Godzilla fucking beams through the Hollow Earth, makes a path, and then Kong was like, what's up? Round two? Dude, it's so fucking dumb.
Bro.
Oh really my stupid. God.
And the thing is, like, oh my God. When you're trying to build up fights, bro, don't try to like force it all the time. We know it's gonna come, but you gotta make it meld together.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Mechagodzilla real quick. So this motherfucker.
Oh,
I was like, their explanation to how it works. Yeah. So it's King Ghidorah's head, right?
Yeah.
Okay, one of the heads.
You took his DNA. You took his DNA. Consciousness and didn't think that was gonna fuck it up. Why you have to use his consciousness? Why?
Right.
There's a
I don't understand why they even need the head. Why don't you just build? It looks like they can just build a robot. Because if you're using just the head, how do they even build the frame and all that other shit too? Mm-hmm. Like, you just need a pilot. It's like Pacific Rim.
Yeah.
Why don't you just do that shit?
Yeah.
Like, you only put the consciousness in there if you don't have a pilot.
Exactly.
So you can control it. But you already have one. So what's the even point of having one?
Yeah. I was like, oh my God, dude. Like,
yeah.
Once he was having his orgasm, I was like, this shit's fucking cheesy as a motherfucker. This is like honestly, this movie felt more cheesier than like the OG ones, like Gaika, the old shit. But like dude, it's just stupid shit after another. And then the rich dude got destroyed easily because he's the nearest to the window,
right?
I did like how Mechagodzilla like turned on. Like that should have just been it. Like he turned on, right? And then he moved on his own. And then he killed, like the design you were talking about, Mechagodzilla's design, like the throw, like the OG design. Right. He actually stood up.
Yeah.
This one was more crouching.
Yeah. And it's like a real lizard. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, they're not. Godzilla, well, actually, Godzilla's always slumped too, so yeah. It makes sense.
But I felt like the OG one looks more, like, scarier.
Yeah, for sure.
This one was just like...
Because it was like, it's fucking Megazord.
Yeah, that's what right. That's what I was thinking.
So do it in
the I like this color too, blue.
Yeah,
it
me
was
too.
Blue. I like this one was red, and I was like, I love red, but I guess you had the Bloods and Crips. It was Bloods and Crips, this movie.
Yeah. So, the second fight in Hong Kong.
Okay, here we go.
That was good. That was really, really good.
Yeah.
But again, I knew it. Okay, Kong won that one, right? Supposedly.
Yeah, because the guy prematurely.
Right, right. Okay. And then fucking after fighting, fucking stomps on him. I was okay. Here's what it is. When he got him on the ground, right? And he put his foot on him.
Yeah.
When they're yelling at each other, I was like. What are you guys doing with me, right? I get that it's like it's them paying respect to each other. Yeah, like, I understand you. You understand me.
I see you.
But I was like,
no. You know what I was thinking? What? I thought Kong was going to say, save Mothra.
That's stupid.
I mean, because that shot was meant for the movie.
Yeah.
Like the movie there, if it was like IMAX or whatever, because I saw the other one in IMAX.
Okay.
Like, that would have been a great shot. But just the fact Godzilla was like, what's up, bruh? You got a new weapon?
It just looked like they were going to keep talking, like roaring at each other for a minute. Like,
watch Godzilla with his hands like trying to do sign language. No disrespect to sign language. I know. But it was like, how do you guys communicate, Godzilla?
I did like the fact that the girl, when he was like kind of dying or whatever, she felt her heartbeat through the ground. Mm-hmm. I thought that was a cool touch.
Yeah,
her, the natives or whatever,
the Iwis.
They're the Iwis.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
The connection that Kong has between them, I like that because it's important to have. Kong's supposed to be like, it is like an extension of the human race.
Yeah,
he's supposed to sympathize with us and he knows how we feel. It's just that he's misunderstood, like my fiance would say. It's just that humans are fucking shit. They like to take control all the time,
colonizers, the
right? So Apex was the one that was trying to control the monsters, right?
You mean monarch?
Monarch, sorry.
From the first few movies, everything was monarch. That's why when you introduce Apex, it was just like, where the fuck did this come from? Mm-hmm.
So Apex is the good.
No, one. They just introduced Apex out of nowhere. The Apex does like prosthetics or like for people, like I guess.
Oh, okay.
So when you heard that, you already knew like, oh, they're building something.
Got it.
They're building something.
Yeah. All right, let's get into that last fight then.
I really liked how
the team up.
So like when they fought, Godzilla was like looking like really fighting like a lizard, and Kong was jumping around the buildings.
Yeah.
And then when you get into Mechagodzilla, all of a sudden it was like sunny. It was like daytime.
Yeah.
I was like, what the fuck?
It was. That's what I was talking about. Godzilla was more agile. Yeah. I like the way he fought in the city. Mm-hmm. Like, I like the fact that they were fighting in the city.
Mm-hmm.
I had this one video game back in the day.
Rampage.
Yes. That reminded me just like
that. Yeah. That's how. Then they made a movie out of that too.
Yeah, that was with
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Garbage. I slept through that game. Yeah.
Godzilla, like. Yeah, I really dig that. Like, now you mentioned it. Rampage was like classic. It was like Nintendo 64.
Yeah, this is like a video game again.
And so this is that Batman versus Superman moment that you knew was going to happen. Mm-hmm. There's going to be that Doomsday, Mechagodzilla, you got to team up. I wish I saw a little bit more combos.
Me too.
I wish like fucking Kong was Godzilla or something. Not that corny, but they were pulling at Mechagodzilla's arms. That's it. But I wanted to see some kind of like.
Did you even want Mechagodzilla in here? I honestly just wanted to see them two fight.
No, I already. But I knew it was gonna happen.
Yeah.
I mean, because like that's what happens when you do post credit scenes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I kind of wanted. I mean, yeah, they didn't plan out their universe that well.
Mm-hmm.
All that shit. But
yeah, if this was supposed to be like the end game. It's like, that's a pretty weak one.
We didn't know it was gonna be end game.
Like, their best movie is just okay. Yeah. That's really sad to me.
I did like when Kong was like fighting Mechagodzilla. And then Godzilla like charged up his axe.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, Godzilla, how'd you know?
That was like an Avengers moment.
Yeah, exactly. Thor hammer. But I hated the Team Godzilla because they were like, oh, let's just spill alcohol into the technology. Oh, my God. What the fuck? Oh,
my God, bro.
What the fuck?
Okay, that's another pet peeve I have. I hate when like nerd or geniuses know exactly what to do with, like, I need to just hack into this computer. Like, I know shit.
I like that they couldn't. But the fact that
I knew that it couldn't, but their solution to it was really fucking stupid. Yeah, you, like
they should have just went with it.
It's like liquid. Oh, let me just pour shit, and it's gonna fuck everything up. Like they didn't know that was gonna happen.
Yeah,
obviously.
Like, how'd you know that was gonna happen?
Right.
This motherfucker is Ghidorah now.
Right.
Galvatron.
Yeah. Basically, it's really stupid. In a way, I like the fact that they did team up, but it's just like.
Predictable,
and it was too quick too. It was like how long was that fight scene? Like 3 minutes?
I don't know. It just blew by, and Kong got CPR too,
bro.
I was like, this is very convenient.
He did it by exploding the thing on his chest, right?
Yeah, the power source, the Infinity Stone.
What if that fucking killed him? Yeah. It's a fucking grenade on his chest,
dude. Bro. I can't wait till like Honest Trailers or. How it should have ended.
He's like a charge. She's the shit.
Because like Kong and like I guess the original movie has some electricity come through him.
Yeah, was it?
Like to beat like Godzilla or fight him. I remember when people were making prediction videos of what's gonna happen, electricity was gonna play into it. I didn't fucking know it's gonna revive Kong.
CPR.
I was like, man, I'd rather see Kong in a fucking suit with like armor team up with Monarch or some shit.
I would have just seen them die. I think Kong would have been better off that way.
How about the way it ended? Like, so Godzilla gets up, Kong gets up, and they look at each other.
Mm.
The whole time I was like, Kong. Godzilla was like, bro, you trying to get this third L? It didn't look like Kong got, like could hold another fight.
Nah, he can't, bro. That's what I'm saying. They answered the question, who would win? Godzilla would win. Now. We know for sure now.
Yeah.
Like even with his axe, he still lost.
Yeah.
So,
fucking Thor,
and he needs a piece of Godzilla just to even like harm him. So,
like they did Kong so bad. The humans who made this film made people who treated Kong so bad.
Right.
Fucking assholes.
And then they ended the movie. He just returns to Hollow Earth. Yeah. And they have a Ground Zero now there.
Yeah.
So I'm like,
they should have ended something where like Kong is the king of like.
Yeah, that's what I was waiting for, something like that. Like, yeah,
have a strong line at the end, like, "Oh, Kong, King."
They just ended with a corny ass fucking song. I was like, "This is not. This is not what I want." The end of a monster movie.
What is this? Guardians of the Galaxy. I didn't even know the song.
Yeah, I didn't know either.
You should have just put King Kong by Jibs,
right?
Something. Or Godzilla with Eminem.
I don't even know, bro. I don't know. Right, anyway, that was Godzilla versus Kong. It was
GVK
overall. I mean, it's fun for what it is. I would never watch it again. I would probably just watch the fight scenes on YouTube or something.
Yeah, but, when they cut it.
Right. Yeah. But, it's a pretty average movie for me.
How much? What would you rate it?
I'd give it a 5.
I'll give it a 6.5.
Really? That's pretty high.
I always rate high just because, if I got, what I wanted, Godzilla versus Kong, that's what I got.
Right.
If the fights were really bad... It would have been way low.
It would have been like a don't even bother. I wouldn't even watch it. So, if they made a sequel or whatever, the theory was what, Pacific Rim? There's supposed to be a crossover.
Yeah, I think that's like kaput now because the whole Pacific Rim uprising.
Right. I didn't even watch the first one. Did you watch it?
I watched the first one.
Was it good?
I thought it was pretty cool. The concept, Idris Elba.
The last scene reminded me of Pacific Rim.
Yeah.
The Hong Kong fight. It reminded me of Pacific Rim.
This would have been the opportunity here, but they fucked up, and I don't even know who Kong's going to be the king of anymore, and what is Godzilla going to do now?
Godzilla's just, I'm just going to chill.
Gonna swim. I'm going to wait till...
take a vacation.
Who's the other people Godzilla's going to fight? Or like,
he fought all the main ones already.
Yeah, but there's like the other ones, like the one from space. There's another one.
Nah, that was just like... those are the corny ones.
Okay.
So he fought King Ghidorah. He fought Mothra and he fought Mechagodzilla. Those are like the top three. And then Kong. So it's like, there's no one else.
They should have a baby Godzilla. I have not seen Godzilla do his signature flying kick.
How's he going to have a baby, though?
I don't know. They never explained that.
That's stupid.
Maybe he should just mate with the 1998 Godzilla.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
The lizard one. Yeah. I don't know. But I would recommend, I want us to watch Shin Godzilla.
Okay.
Just to kind of like compare. Because that's like a masterpiece, apparently, in Japan. Mm-hmm. Like the newest one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I want to see like a really good Godzilla movie.
They should have kept what's his name from the other Godzilla movies, the one that was like, "Let them fight."
He always sounds Ken Watanabe.
Yeah. But he died.
Yeah,
let them fight.
Did you ever watch The Last Samurai?
I seen it as a kid.
Yeah, that was like one of my favorite movies.
I have a DVD.
Yeah, I did too. The double disc. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
the brown one. Yeah. It was brown. Yeah. All right, that shit.
I love that movie, but he has acted the same every single time. Yeah, bro. Yeah. He was in Inception. He acts the same. This movie, he acts the same.
Dark Knight.
Dark Knight too. He was in Dark Knight.
Oh, Dark Knight. Batman Begins.
Ra's al Ghul. Yeah, he acts the same every time. It's just, his English hasn't improved and it hasn't gotten worse. Yeah, so it's fun. So. You're talking about matchups, right?
Yeah, okay.
Let's get into this part.
All right, I'll have some fun matchups that I want Matt to answer.
Okay.
Just from instinct, like, who do you think would win this matchup?
Okay. All
right, so I give you the first one. Thanos versus Darkseid.
Ooh. So Darkseid's supposed to be like the biggest
bad. Originator.
Yeah, the biggest DC villain, right? Mm. Thanos, I know he's like, in the grand scheme of things, he's kind of like in the lower tier.
Yeah,
I don't even know, but I'll pick Thanos.
Thanos? Okay.
Well, hold on. I'll pick MCU Thanos.
Thanos.
He's a badass.
Okay.
Because I know in the comics, he wasn't even really that strong or whatever.
Without the stones.
Without the stones. Yeah.
Okay.
And I like Josh Brolin too.
All right. I got one. I got another I'll one. I'm going to do like multiple media. All right. Okay. Floyd Mayweather versus Manny Pacquiao in their prime, not when they were older.
So what's considered prime for them?
Like 5 years before the fight that happened in 2017, 2018.
That was
like 2012 when they were hot, when the first conversation happened. Who would have won that
I was one? Trying to think of what was Pacquiao's prime? Was it Oscar De La Hoya?
Yeah, I think those I associated when we were in middle school to like high school. I mean, college, early college. That's when Pacquiao was hot.
Right.
Pacquiao.
So I've always hated Mayweather because he's just a fucking asshole, and I hate the whole Team Money shit ever since we were in high school.
Like, yeah,
I know we had a lot of black friends too,
and they call us the Filipinos. Shout out to the boys, Denzel, D. Mitch, and them.
Bro, Deleon, what's his name? Craig.
Yeah, those were fun. Like barbershop talks. Yeah.
But here's the thing about Mayweather. I understand now his talent. He's a tactician fighter. Like he's good at maneuvering. But the thing is, I'm old school when it comes to boxing. I like pound for pound fighters. If you're to duke it out physically, like rock and sock and robots, like you can't dodge.
Yeah.
That's who I think is the best fighter.
Yeah.
But I give more credit to Mayweather now. Since like I've watched him fight,
longevity.
It's just the fact that he's a boring fighter to me.
Yeah.
If you like defense, that's cool. Mm. But Pacquiao, he has both. Yeah. He has good offense and he has good defense. So of course Pacquiao.
I just want to see.
It's not just because he's Filipino, bro.
I wish Pacquiao would have fought Mayweather in their prime, just so I can see Pacquiao's post game interview. That would have been hilarious. I want to thank the people of the Philippines. Shout out to Manny.
And that's another thing with Mayweather too. Like he intentionally waited too long. It's like he waited for Pacquiao to get older.
Yeah.
So he made up so many excuses. Like I can't respect the man for doing that. If you're a fighter and you know you're the best, you would not make up any excuse to fight. You just fight whoever wants to fight you.
Fight the best.
Yeah, at their best or whenever they want to fight.
Yeah.
that fight was supposed to happen in 2011.
Yeah.
And they fought in 2015. That was like way too long. Or like way too long.
17 years. Like throw ones. Yeah, something like that. Like ready to throw ones at any time, any place. I got another boxing one.
Okay.
Who would have won Muhammad Ali versus Mike Tyson?
I'll still pick Mike Tyson.
Iron Mike over the
prime goat. Iron Mike.
Prime
sure,
Iron
bro.
Mike.
Iron Mike is like the perfect boxer in my opinion.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even though I don't care what records say, when you watch that motherfucker train, he's a fucking dog, bro.
Yeah,
he's a pit.
Did you see the interview with Mike and Ali at Arsenio Hall?
Mm-mm.
It was like a throwback, and then like I love the respect between them, like Ollie and Tyson. Like,
I can't imagine Mike being disrespectful to
Ollie. Was like saying like Tyson would have won, and Tyson was like, I don't want any part of this.
That's humble.
So like, I know this is like a long standing boxing debate, but
it's like a Jordan LeBron situation.
Yeah. And so that's why I brought it up, because I was like, I want to see that fight if there was ever a dream matchup, like that speed of Mike and then like Ollie's size, but like being able to move around. Like
Ollie was the originator.
Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
He knows how to maneuver. It's just that when you watch those fights, the Ollie fights,
the OG ones.
Yeah, I hate the way they fight, bro. I know that's really old school fighting, like terrible defense. His defense is maneuvering, but they don't like to put their hands up a lot. So it's like it's hard for me to like compare, because Mike, like, he's like Pacquiao again. Perfect offense, perfect defense. But the thing about Mike, he doesn't even need to play a lot of defense, because he'll knock you out in the first round or so. So as soon as he catches you, you're going to be out. So pound for pound, though, I'll pick Mike.
I think I'm going to weigh on Ollie, because if it's Ollie can go beyond the first round, first three rounds, I think Ollie.
You think he could just like out stamina him?
Out stamina, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that could.
Say that. I think I'm just favor that. last two matchups.
Okay.
You said it already. LeBron versus Mike. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. It's a different one. Okay. This one is more recent.
Okay.
So this was my dream matchup in like 2009. LeBron versus Kobe.
LeBron versus Kobe.
That matchup, like a young LeBron versus like Kobe in his prime. I think that'd get lost in history where LeBron didn't make the finals. It was Orlando that went instead. Who would have won? Now, seeing that, like, now that LeBron is Laker Nation, I don't think Laker Nation fully embraces LeBron because of like Kobe was the guy for 18 years, 20 years.
Okay, you have to pick a year for me so I can get a better.
It was like 2009 Kobe, like after
MVP
like
Kobe.
The year after MVP Kobe and then young LeBron. I think people forget young LeBron was like fucking athletic as shit.
He was something else.
Yeah.
Okay. Now this one's actually kind of hard because Kobe, he lacks certain things when it comes to offense. If he faces a person like LeBron, he could definitely outshoot him. But young LeBron, he would hound him a lot, and he has the body to back him down too. So.
Yeah.
But LeBron's offense didn't pick up until like real LeBron, like all the tricks and all the Miami shooting. Yeah, to Miami. So I think LeBron.
Motherfucker, you got Kobe.
I know. But we're going one on one. If we're talking about who would be a better leader, I'll pick Kobe.
Okay.
Not even Kobe. I don't know.
I pick Kobe. If it was a matchup like Kobe versus LeBron. Kobe's that dog, man.
I know. I'm only iffy because I don't know if Kobe could last going against LeBron all the time.
Size.
Yeah, once LeBron gets on offense, he's gonna attack the basket and Kobe can't stop that all the time.
I'm relying on Kobe's footwork.
Yeah.
I feel like that footwork would do really well on a one-on-one matchup.
Yeah, that's hard, though.
Because LeBron can't go full steam like a freight train in a one-on-one matchup.
That's true. Yeah, that's a tough one. I can't really...
I would love to see LeBron and Kobe fans talk it out. That Nike Kobe commercial.
Okay, I got one for you.
Oh, you got one for me? Yeah. Fuck.
Goku versus Vegeta.
I thought you said Goku versus Superman. Nah. That's the debate. That's the death battle original.
Okay, let's do that then.
Goku versus Superman. That's
a thing?
That's a thing. That's death battle.
Goku would lose.
Man. Ultra Instinct Goku? I think Goku would fucking lose because he would probably give Superman a sense of being. But I pick Goku just so I love Goku.
Just because you like him.
Goku, even though he has the same backstory as Superman.
Yeah.
Alien goes to Earth. I pick Goku, shit. Man. Fuck that. Nah, man. I pick Goku.
I didn't even put that together.
You didn't know that?
No.
Both from another planet exploding.
Both got adopted.
Yeah.
Wow, what the fuck?
We just learned this today.
That's really fucking sad.
But yeah, those were our matchups. Dream matchups. That was a short one. That's a short one, but...
What was your last one?
Oh, that was it.
That was
I had only four. Goku and Superman.
Okay.
I was just testing this.
Let's see if I can think of one more.
I was gonna say Voltron versus Megazord, but
what the That's hella random. Oh, shit.
I was going to do like Bruce Lee. Who would Bruce Lee fight? But like, there's Jackie Chan. Jackie Chan?
Yeah.
You think Jackie can hold his hold a flame?
No, Bruce Lee would kick his ass.
Yeah, I know. Hitmon Chan, Hitmon Lee.
No, they won. I know, seriously. But Jackie Chan will hold his own too. Let me see if I can think of like a football player.
Football's hard. That's the team sport.
I know, I know. It's like, fine. Another one.
See, this is why this is interesting dream matchup.
I wish you should have presented to me first.
Sorry. This is a mini review.
All right, maybe we'll do another one of these days.
Yeah.
All right. So anyway, if you guys liked our video, or actually, if you guys watched Godzilla versus Kong, drop a comment down below. Tell us what you thought about the movie. You heard our thoughts, so we want to know what you guys thought too. Up next, we got Mortal Kombat on HBO Max.
Mortal Kombat.
It's gonna be next month. So we're that's this month.
Oh yeah, it's April.
That's 2 weeks from now.
2 weeks, 2.5, 3 weeks.
Shit.
Fuck.
Damn.
We're busy.
So yeah, if you guys liked our shit, like, comment, subscribe. Listen, go back to Spotify, listen to all our other episodes.
Yo. Shout out to Kuya P, Show Pow Show, Nerds of Color, new release Wednesday. Shout out to Glenn, shout out to OG Moose. We're reviewing Falcon and Winter Soldier.
So I will not be participating because I can't.
You got work, but it's all good. We'll let y'all know. And also, we would like to celebrate our 1 year anniversary of the Talk Back podcast. So thank y'all for fucking with us. We're from the Bay, showing that Bay love for nerd culture. Just drop any suggestions, recommendations of what you guys want us to talk about.
Right. I mean, if you guys saw our Fave 5, we got more of that too. So
yeah,
that'd be fun.
Dude, we hit 1 year. Woo! And pandemic is still ongoing.
If you guys could help us out, share with a friend, tell a family member, check us out. Because we want to keep doing this for a while. You know, it's a nice stress reliever for us to talk about the shit we love. Sometimes it could be a chore when we don't like something, but
like today,
it's still fun to talk about. But yeah, we got more on the way, guys.
Send it off
from the top of the dome
to the back of the pack.
We are
the Top Back Podcast.
Peace.